In this video, we are going to study about the amniotic cavity, a fluid-filled cavity which is known as the amniotic cavity appears in the second week of development between the germ disc and the trophoblast. The roof of the cavity is formed by a layer of flattened cells which is known as the amnioblast, which lines the inner aspect of the cytotrophoblast. The cavity is floored by the tall columnar cells of the ectodermal layer of the germ disc. The roof and the floor, they meet at the periphery of the disc, forming the amnio-ectodermal junction. With the extension of the extraembryonic coelom, the outer surface of the amniotic cavity and the yolk sac are covered by a thin layer of primary mesoderm, which is continuous with the primary mesoderm of the chorion at the caudal end of the germ disc through the connecting stalk. The formation of the embryonic folds allows the amniotic cavity to surround the outer surface of the embryo. As a result, the amnio-ectodermal junction, they converge towards the ventral surface of the embryo to form the umbilical cord, which contains the primary mesoderm of the connecting stalk, the umbilical vessel, and other associated structures. The amniotic cavity gradually increases in size at the expense of the extraembryonic coelom, and eventually the amnion and the chorion leeway are fused. Finally, the extraembryonic coelom is completely obliterated except a small part which is contained in the proximal part of the umbilical cord up to the 10th week of the intrauterine life. The embryos of the reptiles, birds and mammals, they possess amniotic cavity, hence they are named as amniotes. Fishes and amphibians are devoid of amniotic cavity and they are called as anamniotes. Next we'll see about the amniotic fluid. The amniotic fluid is also called as the liquor amni, is clear and watery, containing about 2% solids, which includes inorganic salts, urea, protein and a trace of sugar. The source of the fluid still remain unsettled. It may be fetal from the amniotic cells, maternal or from both the mother and the fetus. The amniotic cells are cuboidal over the placenta and flattened over the rest of the amniotic cavity. Ultrastructurally, the amniotic cells presents microvilli and they consist of two types. One is the Golgi types, the other one is the fibrillar type. The Golgi type presents prominent Golgi apparatus and abundant rough surfaced endoplasmic reticulum. The fluid gradually increases in amount up to 6 months of pregnancy, and its volume relative to the fetus diminishes towards the end of the gestation when the fluid amounts to about 1 liter. Next we'll see the functions of the amniotic fluid. It acts as a protective cushion for the embryo against shock, blows or pressure. The embryo is suspended by the umbilical cord and literally it swims in the fluid. The fluid maintains a uniform pressure for the proper growth and the differentiation of the delicate tissues of the embryo. It also allows the fetal movements and maintains a constant environmental temperature. During parturition, the amniotic sac forms a hydrostatic wedge and helps to dilate the cervical canal. Next, we'll see the factors regulating the volume and the composition of the liquor amni. The fetal urine is added to the amniotic fluid from the fourth month onward, since the metanephric kidneys start functioning from that period. Probably from the fifth month, the fetus swallows the amniotic fluid, which is absorbed through the gut into the bloodstream and thence passes into the maternal blood through the placenta. Next, we'll see the abnormalities of the liquor amnio. First is the hydramnios. This is a condition when the volume of the amniotic fluid exceeds 2 liters. When the fetus is unable to swallow the amniotic fluid due to esophageal atresia or in neurogenic defect of the swallowing reflex in anencephaly, the large amount of liquor amnio is collected. The next condition is oligamnios. In this condition, the fluid is scanty in amount and the oligamnios may be associated with congenital agenesis of the metanephric kidneys. Next, we'll see about the amniocentesis. Sometimes aspiration of the amniotic fluid is known as amniocentesis, is done through the cervix or the anterior abdominal wall. This procedure is adopted to investigate the nuclear sexing of the fetus in some sex-linked diseases. The enzyme estimation of the fluid and other chemical tests may be helpful to diagnose the gross fetal malformation.